Hello everyone, this is Arti Yapo Manager speaking, and yes, you are looking at FM Fanboys right now. And today I'm going to show you how you can actually counter your opponent's formation in your FM 2-0-0 game. But before I begin, let me just pay tribute to the author of FM Fanboys who allowed me to use their tactics creator in their tactical playbook, you know, feature of their site. And really thank him for he allowed me to use, you know, his features at will, you know, the features of his blog at will. And without further ado, let me just show you what I'm going to share with you. And if you have checked out my previous videos, I've actually, you know, came up with the how you can counter the 4-2-3-1 deep formation, which was used by Liverpool in my game. And well, feel free to check them out. But today, I'm just going to share with you the situation where I won Arsenal in the Barclays Premier League with my 4-4-2 formation. And they were using the formation that you're seeing here, the 4-5-1 diamond shape formation. Now, this formation has strengths simply because, you know, you have a lone striker right here. And this lone striker has a lot of space to run around and roam around. Yes, with he has a lack of support of the other striker, but if you have a prolific striker that has good dribbling skills and flair, you can actually, you know, be very very effective in this build. Because I've noticed that when the computer or the AI or your opposition, when they use 4-2-4 formation against the 4-4 against my tactics, what happens is that there will be four defenders right at my, you know, right at my defense line, which is very 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 common for any setup. Which also means that you have eight players just at this small space off the pitch, and you're not gonna allow your players to run around when you have so many people at this part of the pitch, you know. At this level, you can only depend on your skills with, you know, your technical skills such as passing or crosses. And if your, you know, technicalities of the team is not solid, you are not going to get goals easily. Whereas if you have this setup, if you have a striker that can dribble, can connect with the ball and has good flair, you're going to probably outrun and outmaneuver the defenders and score. Even, you know, players like Didier Drogba, players like, you know, Thierry Henry, that's what they usually do. And furthermore, this is not the only attacking option that the 4-5-1 diamond shape, you know, formation actually offer. Now you can see here that you have the attacking midfielder left and attacking midfielder right. They're not just going to be standing there, they are going to be running up to supply crosses into the middle of the park to connect with the lone striker. Or they can even run in, because there's so much space, they can actually run in to do some true pass or support. Furthermore, this is not just the only attacking option. They can actually ask that central midfield to run up. And central midfield is good at long shots. And in my previous encounter at FM 2009, what happened was Cesc Fabregas is quite good at long shots, and he can snipe balls in from, you know, from outside the penalty box. And that's a major threat if you have no good central defender, central midfielder, excuse me, which Arsenal actually has. He has Dean Nelson, he has actually Cesc Fabregas. Alright, and defensive, and another attacking option is, of course, is the left and right backs can run up, supply, through pass, or even run up all the way if your opponent decides to be very very attacking. And can supply, of course, through pass or passes to the midfield or to the wingers, alright, the attacking wingers. So this is an effectively good build if you really want to use them for your own team. But if you ask me, I actually always look forward to play against this formation Now I'm gonna show you why. I usually use the 4-4-2 formation. So I have four defenders at the rear. You can see right here that my left and right backs can actually man mark their attacking midfielder left and attacking midfielder right. Now what I usually do when I want to defend is I usually zonal mark this portion, my two central defenders. Now in FM2010, the default settings for central midfielders is always man marking. And if you're against a prolific striker, just one sole striker, that is not good. Because let's say this defender is man marking the striker, and this is just standing out of nowhere. No, he's looking for somebody to man mark. What if this player, this prolific player, runs to the right? Alright, what happens? There's one big block of space here. Fabregas can run up and snipe the ball in from long range. That's how I conceded goals in FM2009. So I learned my lesson, never to put man marking when I'm against a sole striker. Instead, if I guard this area, this guy can run anywhere, but he usually has problems running ahead of the two defenders who are zonal marking this area. And if they're gonna do long shots, it's gonna be a little bit tougher because they can actually block the line of sight, to the goal, and actually help the goalkeepers even to distract them. And that is how I actually counter the attacking options. Furthermore, please do not forget that in your 4-4-2 formation, or in my 4-4-2 formation, I also have central midfielders, and of course have wingers, left and right wingers. And what happens is I usually man mark the central midfielders. Now I do not need to man mark the defensive midfield. That's a waste of resources, simply because he has problems being an attacking option. He has quite a lot of pitch to run. He can't really run up. And if he runs up, it breaks the formation flow. It makes it look funny. And so usually I do not man mark or even zonal mark. I actually just close him down if I could, just to stop him from supplying balls to the central midfielders. Alright? And of course my wingers are free to run up. And these players will actually be countered by my left and right midfielders. Alright, so that is how I actually successfully counter most of my opponents, and it has worked pretty well even in FM2009 and FM2008. So that is how you can defend against this formation defensively, and the rest of your attacking options is up to you, up to your own formation. Alright. That is all that I'm going to show you for today. And if you like what you see, please subscribe to my YouTube channel at RTR Football Manager, or you can visit my blog at footballmanagersite.com. And if you have any special requests on featuring some formations, specific formations, do let me know, and I hope to cater to you. Alright, signing off, RTR Football Manager.